Please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Let's invite our two experts for the afternoon, Sharmila Joshi and Prakash Gaba, joining in our studios to answer all the stock queries that are coming in. So good afternoon to both of you. Our first question comes in from Charul Jain, who's on the line with us from Mumbai. Hi, Charul. How can we help you?
Hi, good afternoon. Many congratulations to Team CNBC 18 for putting up such great shows every day. My query is on United Spirit, and I just really enjoy Mangalam one-liners and with Nigel Spencer in Chartbusters. And my query is on United Spirit. Post the split, I'm holding more than 800 shares at the rate of around 670 around.
Okay.
So I just want to know, now since that I'm holding it for last 2 years, I'm a long-term investor only. I just want to know whether at what level, if I'm in profit, that I should book out, because I got a chance to book my profit when it touched some 4,000 rupees, but I missed that chance. And post that, it has gone down, post the degrade from Citi, I suppose. So I just want to know the level at which I can book out, or shall I hold it for longer term?
All right, Charul, well, do you want your advice first, or do you want a one-liner from Mangalam first? Okay, Mangalam, I hope you have something ready.
I don't have something ready, but I just said this is a weekend or the week full of vice, and how better than have someone come and speak about United Spirits. But Charul, are you a consumer or just an investor? Okay, just an investor. No, you're lying on national TV. This is Friday.
You put me on trouble. You're on national television and you're asking me questions.
All right.
One-liner.
I'm a teacher like you.
I think Charul has given a one-liner.
Charul has given a one-liner now. Okay, so now we'll get you an advice on this. Prakash, what would you say?
Every week we have one Friday, one Saturday.
Okay.
What's wrong with the stock? It's a beautiful stock, good, hold, long-term. In fact, since you bought it at a higher price, it's trading lower. Technically, it's in a good place where it can bounce from. So I think United Spirits is a buy, hold, and that's it, buy and hold.
Sharmila?
Yeah, I would concur largely, because, you know, we did see some amount of correction coming in because I think the numbers weren't perceived as very great. But I think Charul is a long-term investor, and yes, I can understand her pain because she feels she missed, you know, when the stock was at 4,000. Of course, I mean, there has been a stock split, etc. So it's not that it's gone from 400 to 4,000 to 600, but at the same time, it's off the price that she bought at. So I think that continue to hold. I agree with Prakash. I think, you know, the sector itself is so good that yes, you may have seen concern for some of their brands, etc. But I think going forward, these things will average out. So I would continue to hold the stock.
All right, Charul. So the advice for you is hold your drink and have it too. So that is as far as United Spirits is concerned. Thanks a lot for calling in. Meanwhile, keep your eye out on the screen. We are getting in some commentary from Finance Minister Arun Jaitley, who says they may cut or they may mull cutting GST on cement, as well as large screen TVs, as well as air conditioners, if the demand increases, once the demand increases. Remember the previous GST meeting, we did not see air conditioners seeing a GST cut. So there we have Voltas reacting positively to that. The cement stocks, which were buzzing earlier itself, have some positive news coming in out there as well. But the large screen set is something which should keep all the other stocks up as well. Something like a Merck should come up for you. They operate Onida TVs. And earlier, the GST cut that came in, that was on TVs which were sub 29 inches. So now large screen TVs coming under the lower rate for GST should be positive for them. Blue Star is moving higher. Voltas is moving higher. We'll have something like a Merck Electronics, MIRC, where they operate the Onida range of TVs. So let's see whether that stock is moving or not. But as of now, these are the only comments that we're getting in from Arun Jaitley, who says that the GST Council, who has almost phased out the 28% category in the last 13 months, may see some more products come in the lower rates.
And, you know, like you said, it's a week of vice. And Mr. Jaitley, they're saying only luxury and sin items would be in the 28% bracket. All right. Next query coming in from Mrs. Firoza Contractor. She writes to us from Mumbai. She wants to invest 10 lakh rupees. The stock she has selected is Kotak Mahindra Bank for the long term. Wants to know if it's the right time for her to be entering the market. Sharmila, let me come to you first on this. Banks are doing well. For somebody who's looking to make a sizable investment in a select bank, one, is it advisable to put all your eggs in one basket? And two, is this the right time actually for her to be making that investment? Shouldn't she just wait for a quarter for things to normalize, stabilize?
Well, she's actually speaking about Kotak Bank. So the numbers, I think, are out there. So I don't think that, you know, waiting for more time on that, in that kind of a bank really matters. What matters is the price the bank is trading at, especially if you look at its price to book valuation. So while I think the numbers are great and I have really no concerns on Kotak Bank in that sense, I think that if you had to buy Kotak Bank, try and buy it on dips. And, you know, very honestly, I think the new kids on the block seem to be RBL and Bandhan Bank. Those are also available in that sense, cheaper to their price to book kind of valuation. And there, because they're growing, the growth going ahead also seems better in these banks. So I think, you know, that is something that you can consider. But if you want to buy Kotak Bank, try and buy it on dips.
All right, buy Kotak Bank on dips. That's the word coming in on Kotak Bank. But just keep an eye out on Westlife Development. The management has told us that the same store sales growth has come in at 24.1%. Remember, the revenues grew by 30%. Same store sales growth of 24.1% is something that will go down well with Street. In fact, for Westlife Development itself, prior to the last two quarters, eight quarters in a row, they did go ahead and beat Jubilant Foodworks on their same store sales growth. It was the previous quarter where Jubilant Foodworks did 26.5%, which was a six-year high for them. In that, Westlife Development did about 25.1%. And this quarter, Jubilant Foodworks did 25.9%, mildly trailing behind as Westlife Development, up 24.1%. Consumer sentiment would have been better for quick service restaurants, given the youth sporting events that took place in the quarter, as well as a low base aiding all of them. The stock moves higher as we speak, up 15%, 24.1%. That compares with 25.1% quarter on quarter. And it comes on a favorable base as well. Actually, it comes on a higher base of 8.7% in Q1 FY18. Now, I think we'll take a short break on that. Come back. We focus on some more stocks and these as we return with the news that Westlife Development is at the high point of the day.
Welcome back. As we welcome you back with the news that the Nifty is at the high point of the day. So it's almost a century now. So above that 11,250 odd mark and the mid-cap index higher by about 200 points. All right, let's get back to answering some more queries then. A. Bhagiraj writes into us from Bihar. She holds 1,000 shares of Bank of Baroda. Remember, they're due to report numbers today. She's bought it at 172 rupees. She's been holding on for about 7 months, a medium term investor, and wants to know what she should do. So, Prakash, I know it's an unfair question ahead of earnings, but, you know, I think a lot of that has already been factored in. Therefore, for somebody like our caller, what would you advise?
Add some more. Okay. It looks like low levels on the entire PSU basket is bottomed out. Looks like this is an up move here. After more, and what you add, exit somewhere closer to around 150 zones. And what you already have, continue holding it.
And Sharmila, your view?
As Sumaira said, we've seen a bit of a run-up in Bank of Baroda. I think the cheer has come ever since we saw Canara Bank numbers. Mm. So wait and see what the numbers are and then take a call. But for now, I think it's a hold.
All right, do remember that the management will be addressing the press at 6 p.m. So we'll find out some more color regarding their earnings. And of course, we'll have the numbers by then too. So watch out for that. And of course, there's a special interview as well, which you can catch through the weekend. All right, well, with that, let's shift focus then to some more numbers that have come through. And before that, just a word on the market, actually. Market's looking good at the moment, Mangalam. So heading higher, I think.
Yeah, there's a century which the Nifty has hit as we speak. Sumaira, a couple of these IT stocks, they're doing well. TechM should come up for you. That one's moved a little higher as we speak. From the mid-cap end of things as well, a double century for the mid-cap index. So closing in on the record high for the Nifty Bank, CG Power, that's the stock that should come up for you right now. That one's gained, had a good week so far, up about 8% this week. Crompton Greaves Power now adds on to its gains, has just suddenly spiked to the high point of the day. Cement Pack is doing well, has been doing well for the last couple of days, aided by ACC results, followed by Ambuja Cements results. And now we have India Cements which has moved to the high point of the day. But it is earnings season. We have Shriram Transport reported its best ever quarter. The AUM growth came in at an 8-quarter high of 22.3%. So to discuss and detail those numbers, we have Mr. Umesh Revankar, the MD and CEO of the company, joining us now. Thanks a lot, Mr. Revankar, for joining in. First up, if you could tell us, you know, what the impact of the new AXEL rule would be if implemented on your AUM growth. Will this lead to reduction in NPA?
See, if you look at the way the notification has come, it is, strictly speaking, it is supposed to be on the new vehicle that are going to be launched. There also, it suggests that there has to be some configuration change in the vehicle to carry heavy load. So, the design change has to be done. And the vehicle manufacturers have to produce a vehicle which can carry more weight. The second aspect is whether existing vehicle would be able to carry this excess, the additional weight, which can happen only when a respective RTO gives a increase on the certificate of registration. So that means every RC book need to be restated on the gross weight that can be taken. So we are not very sure. But right now what will happen is people would carry higher weight even in existing vehicle when there is a confusion, and people, that will be advantageous. It is not that people were not carrying a heavy, higher load. Many of the loads which are within the state, they were always carrying the higher load, but only the intra-state only were not carrying the extra load, or they are carrying the right load. So the impact for us is limited because most of our vehicle, more than 80-85% of our vehicles are local vehicles, not a long route vehicle. So they were carrying a little higher weight. But one advantage is the local, they will not be able to put into any fine or any issues on running the vehicle. So that will help them to earn better. So I feel it will help us, the customers, to earn more revenue.
All right, fair point there. The loan growth, that's remained strong due to robust disbursement. Disbursement to AUM ratio has also improved to over 40% in the first quarter.
See, if you look at the way last year when BS4 was introduced, the many of the manufacturers were not ready with the vehicle. So many of the sales got postponed to the second quarter. So the comparing Q on Q, year on year on the first quarter sales may not be appropriate. So our numbers were high. And we will be able to increase our volume even in the second quarter or third quarter. But the only thing is, normally July, August are weak month for sale of a heavy vehicle due to mining and infra activity come to a halt because of the monsoon. So that could be lower dispersal as far as a new vehicle is concerned. But the used vehicle demand is quite high, especially in the rural area. Both the used vehicle and tractor demand is quite high. So we are confident of maintaining the loan growth. And whatever the initial guidance what we gave, 18-20%, we should be easily able to achieve it.
Mr. Revankar, good afternoon, sir. So CV sales are looking good. What's your guidance then on disbursement growth ahead?
See, this is only in internal discussion. We have not really discussed beyond that. It has not even come up to board level. So we may not be able to talk about it much. Only when there is when we see a very good advantages for our investors, because there should be advantages in cost of borrowing and there should be advantage in OPEX. So if there is an advantage on both side, liability and asset side, then we can discuss on, we'll place it before the investor, then we'll take it forward.
Mr. Revankar, thank you very much for joining in. So that's the word from the management of Shriram Transport. We'll take a very quick break, come back, and we'll get back to answering lots more stock queries. Stay tuned.
Welcome back. Some stocks doing well. Tata Steel, which was holding up in the green and has now extended its gain up at the high point of the day. Along with that, we have REC and PFC. Both those stocks were buzzing around yesterday. They too have suddenly spiked and currently moving together to the high point of the day. So the REC-PFC twins are sitting with a gain of almost 4.5-5% each. So with that, actually, we'll move on to our next query. We have Akriti writing to us from Pune, holds 200 shares of ICICI Bank at 292 rupees, wants to know the future of this stock for the next 1 year or 1.5 years or so. Sharmila, coming to you, they have their results today. The stock has a lot more triggers for it going ahead, perhaps an impending change at the top as well. So with that in mind, for one and a half year, would you recommend, what would you recommend a person do in ICICI Bank?
Results are today. So first of all, let's get that out of the way. But I think, clearly, as you said, the concerns for ICICI Bank and what you're expecting to hear in terms, going ahead is, it's really very little related to do with the kind of numbers that they will deliver. So I think that it might be a good strategy, especially since you're a long-term investor, to really switch out of the bank. And I would think that, we had a query earlier on Kotak Mahindra Bank, so maybe look at a bank like that. Or I think, mentioned an RBL or a Bandhan Bank. We've had numbers from both IndusInd Bank as well as Yes Bank. Yes Bank, in fact, has corrected post numbers. So, that is also available at an attractive level. So I would really switch out of ICICI Bank, especially, given the fact that today are numbers. So use that as an opportunity and exit the stock.
Okay, Prakash, what's your sense? You see higher levels in store, perhaps back to those 300 odd levels?
In fact, I like the structure near the lows. The way it's bounced back, the kind of spring bounce closer to around 270 zones, tells me that there's upside here. Perhaps we can see an up move. The up move could last to around 300 or 305 or 10 zones. We'll see how it goes and negotiates those zones. But I think up to 300, 310 is a possibility out there.
All right, our final query on the show coming in from Arushi, who's written to us from Bengaluru. She holds 60 shares of Reliance Power at 912 rupees. She's bought in just a short while ago, about 2 months ago, but she is a long-term investor and wants to know what she should do. So again, over here, earnings expected this afternoon. Ahead of that, Prakash, it's very close, actually. I think just, 6-7 rupees away from its 52-week high. You see higher levels still?
I like the structure near the between 900 to 1010. That's been so much of consolidation and a broken up. It's a breakout from that zones. It's not stopping at new high. I think it's going beyond that. It's a matter of time it's going there. But meantime, I would say the 1050, 1020, a strong support zone to work with Reliance. And as long as it whole upside is on, it may consolidate for some while, but looks like it's heading up.
All right. Thanks a lot for that, Prakash. Remember, you can catch the RIL management briefing on the first quarter numbers at 6:15 p.m. only on CNBC TV18 today. With that, we wrap on your thoughts, but do remember to email us your queries. We will address them with our experts. Stay tuned to CNBC TV18 Closing Bell to take you through the last trading hour of this week.